Hello then guys, and welcome to today's video. I'm Casual5, and just to say, we accidentally didn't buy anyone in the transfer window, which is fine by me because I actually didn't want to buy anyone, but we forgot to buy someone. You guys didn't tell me anyone, so we didn't buy anyone. So then guys, welcome back to today's video. I'm Casual5, and on today's video we play Partick Thistle in the cup, in the league side. Then we have a Europa League game, which you guys didn't want to cut. You guys didn't smash to like to 5, well, you got to me to 4 or 5, so you didn't get me to 6, which I promised to do that show. So we're not doing the show anymore, which is really okay for me, which I don't really care about. But yeah, hopefully we can do well in this game and put us to where I want to be. Just to say, we have Partick Thistle, then we have the other game, then we have another game. So we have 3 games in this episode. We don't. Two are going to be simmed, one isn't. So, no. 2 games this game, they're both not going to be simmed today. The 2 games that we're playing. So yeah, let's go into the games. Hey guys, now we're into the game. Partick Thistle, the lowest ranked team, they're 12th in the league to score goals, which is okay for me. So here we go then, into the game. I can't tell you what the game is because I can't tell you what team, what the players are. Well, I can, but they don't have the referees today, the commentators today, due to you guys didn't comment down below about if you want to commentate on or not. So I'm just going to leave them off for this game. Please comment down in the next one and I'll be happy with that. You have spoken though, and you do want me to do a stream, but I don't know what it's on yet because the two are still 50-50-ish, like two are both the same percentage, so I thought I would leave that until the end. So here we go then into the game. Lovely to see today, a lovely team here today. Next match is against these Irish losers. Now, disappointment for them, I don't think it will be. Well, anyway, they'll be playing at this ground probably. Like these guys are, what they're calling it for this, as the Lewis with the save there, brilliantly saved. And I don't think Lewis really knows what he's got to do here, he doesn't. Lewis with another shot there, just wide, and he can now. All he has to do is click it at the pitch there. Not that far really it clicks, but it gets to the player there anyway. It does. He can pass it to Hayes. Hayes. You can pass that in there to... Oh, and he can. But he apparently... Oh, it's a penalty. It's a handball from the player. Apparently the ref called it a handball. Yes, it was in anyway from the player. It was in anyway from... Rooney. We're not going to let Rooney take this, guys. We're going to give it to our player who I bought on only for today's game. It's Taylor, the only player I bought on for this game, who can step up. And it's saved by the keeper. What a save from the keeper there to deny us from the penalty spot. You can watch the replay in a minute, where you can. Disappointment from the penalty spot there. That is disappointing. And lo and behold, we should be 2-0 up, really. We should be 1-0 up, maybe 2. And I definitely don't think we should be doing that. Really, the goals for is the worst record they've ever had, this home team. Yeah, as it cuts up now to Rooney, who can pass that, he can to Sheen, but he can't really because he's not there at all really. As Logan tries to get there, but it's Hayes who tries to get the ball. As Sheen or Shine, I don't know, say that name actually. We're going to correct myself if I do correct myself if I'm wrong. But as we turn away now, there we go, now into the box, we're going to come now for this corner. In it goes. Headed on there by the keeper, clears it out. But the player there, outside the box there with the shot. And it was Reynold. There with the clearance. Disappointment there for him. He couldn't capitalise on a thing that came out to him there. He should have actually took a better shot there. The away fans actually were happy with that, I think. Today, I'm expected nothing but a win. Because this is the lowest ranked... Not the lowest ranked team in the league, I don't think. They're the lowest ranked team in the league. But they have only scored 4 goals in this whole season so far, and they've only played 3 games. That's quite disappointing for us. We've scored a bit more than that, but I think you guys have already spoken. Actually, you have. Here, if you really want me to do more of the Newcastle one, then just comment in the comments, Newcastle. Just comment Newcastle exclamation mark if you really desperately want me to do Newcastle. If you don't desperately want me to do Newcastle, just say, not. If you don't want me to do Newcastle, just put not Newcastle. I know what you mean. If you just put stuff that I know what you mean, then do that. As Paulette tries to pass that to Rooney there, but can't. And this first half really has just been a bit sloppy, and that's why I'm going to show the whole first half. I'm going to show the whole game of this one. Your next game is going to be chipped up, which means the best bits of the next game we're going to show you. We are, as it's up to Rooney there, Adam Rooney now can take the shot. I think that's a relative of Rooney's. Now, people, my friends who I speak to sometimes, who you might have heard on the last stream, said that the last video episode, that sorry about the ultimate team and that, they said that he might be relative. He said then he's not a brother of Rooney's and he's not a relative of Rooney's. Well, Rooney praises him as a relative, so Rooney was the only sibling, I know, but was that his like mum's friends or mum's brothers? You never know, you know what I mean? Like, there is their family still connected? But anyway, is it 2 minutes of time here now? It is, as the keeper there. We were trying to buy a new keeper, right? But I couldn't. But anyway, we've had 3 shots on target, 3 shots altogether. 2 shots they've had, 1 on target. We've had less possession, but we've made no tackles. 1 foul, though. Hard we've got somehow, and 1 corner we've had, and 1 penalty we've had, actually, we missed. Which, as we speak, we have a really okay team, as Stocks, as O'Connor is now going to come on for the 86 rated, who is Taylor, who has got a yellow card. The only substitute we're going to do there. As here he comes on, the away crowd, get a little bit of cheer there. You can hear the cheer from the away crowd there, to say the least. But I'm still that cold, guys, I talked about ages ago. I sound funny, like not sound like myself. I've been to the dentist today. I've got a numb gum. Pretty much I had to have a filling, some dye put on my teeth. So the dye, they had to numb my mouth anyway to put on my teeth. They didn't have to numb my mouth, but they had to put some back, they had to put some gel on my gum. And Adam Rooney now with a shot from Adam Rooney. Oh, just wide from Adam Rooney there, but whiskers away there from Adam Rooney. You'll see the penalty highlights at the end of this match, and we'll talk a bit about the match as well, think about it. The transfer window is closed, as I told you at the start of this video, and we're going to buy anyone. That's because, what I tried to say, I forgot to do a video on the new transfer window. I did tell you if you wanted to win players, nobody wanted the players, but I tried to get 2 keepers. Heaton, Paul Heaton, for 10 million, because that's for 5 million, but they said no, I wanted about 8 million. As they're making a sub now, Adam Barton on and Frazier off. And they said they wanted more for him, so I was like, okay, how much more? And they said they wanted about 10 to 12,000, just over the bar again there from Paulette, and then I tried to get a really young keeper from Millwall and not Millwall, sorry, not what I'm saying, Millwall, but from a club in the Championship, and he wouldn't let. They said he's a great player that they don't want to get rid of. So Mustafi, 38 million to Arsenal was the good deal here. We're going to show you the highlights of the rest of this match now. We are maybe going to show you some highlights in a bit. If we won't show the whole game, we probably won't. But anyway, it crossed in now. Headed on there, is it? Good try there for the header, but back in it goes. And it's straight at the defender there. But really, the defence should be clearing this away, and they should be on the counter here. They're looking like they're on the counter now. Look, they are, as we're trying to catch up with them here. Dooland. Here, still in the ball, Dooland is. As the crowd here, I think in the last, this is their 4th game of the season, will know that you don't win every game, as I can explain, because they will be like, not that bad, really. They've only seen, if they've been at home for all the games so far, they've only seen four goals in this ground. The away support as well have only seen four goals in possession. So it's not that bad, really. It's not, I can honestly say. There is a chance, though, is for these teams to really develop and put into context. But as I say, I don't really think it will be, though. A good match. If they take the shot, they're just wide. Literally just wide. If you want to watch that again, we'll watch that at the end of the match. That was just whiskers wide. And lo and behold, I actually do believe we can win this game now from that decision. As well, this game's going to be the full one. Remember now, I told you I'm going to do a full game and a highlight game. The highlight game is going to be the Europa League game, which I have to win. I don't have to, but I have to do well in it. If I want to do well in the Europa League, you know me. Europa League qualifications. The team have told me, the executives and chairmen and all that, say they want me to qualify for Europa League this season. So I decided, yeah, go on then. Last season, in real life, I don't think Aberdeen qualified, but in this game, because it was all like away teams, and no, I just randomised it, and it finally came up with Aberdeen saying no in the Europa League, so I just kept it as it was. Don't say anything. As they've scored, Partick Thistle, who've only scored four goals this season, have scored a goal. They have, and it is a good goal, actually. I don't know why I'm talking about Europa League and stuff. I can concentrate on the game. But it was Fannigan there with a goal. And if that, pretty much near the end of the game there, has probably sealed them the win, then I don't know what happened, really. As we now can play up the ball here, we can look lovely bit of play here from Logan, who can take the shot there just over the bar, but it was a chance that Logan should have scored, as the away home crowd here are actually still cheering. Here they are singing their song quite loudly here. They are, you can hear them, they're happy to see a goal in, they're happy to see a win probably. Here they are today. If we lose to this team, hearts were bottom, we did draw with them, but it's disappointing if we lose to this team. It will be today. It will be really disappointing to lose. Probably not. But the team who have the shittest and lowest score rating of goals this season, which to me is quite disappointing that they've got their fifth against our team, who we can clear it up quickly. And we're now going to quickly go on the counter. Here we are with Paulette, who is going to try and go past them all here, but can't, as it's cleared away. Here it is. As we're now going to get the ball back. Here we are. As we're giving away a free kick. Here we have, which is really annoying. Here we have, if when we simulate the games, I wish we could make our own subs and that kind of stuff. I actually see the game like a manager game, whatever you call it. But EA, please something do that if that's possible. As it's going to be crossed up, here it is. Whipped up it goes here, headed away it is, and cleared. And it's a free kick just on the edge of the box here. Apparently it was a handball, because on this I put handballs on, like normal football. And it's supposed to be a handball there. It's going to be the last kick of the game, this will be, to decide if it will go into the back of the net or not, and it hasn't. And there we go, the home crowd will cheer. They've got a win here, part of the official half. Now we're looking at the misses that we've had here. We're going to go back to the missed penalty that we did. Disappointment there for the missed penalty. Here it is. No, they won't show you the missed penalty. They haven't got the missed penalty on here. Here's the recap here. No missed penalty recap, but we're going to go back to their miss anyway. It wasn't after the goal, it was before the goal, it was this one. It was actually, this is what I said, look. That's how, so it was quite, from what the angle you saw first, quite close. From my angle it wasn't. Anyway guys, that was the game. Disappointment there for us. We do lose the game. We're going to check where we are in the league, and I'll get back to you. So then, here we go with the standings. We are, as we speak, 7th. Where were Partick Thistle? Were okay, they were. They were there, look. So they have scored a few. They've scored 10 goals and against 4. So it was a 4 plus 4, was it? I don't know why I said that anyway. Forget about what I just said anyway. So we're 7th on 9 points, on 8 points here. We are 8 points. We really do need to get into the top half, but for today, the end of this video, the last bit of the video, we have this game and then we're seeing the next one, is the Dundalk game. Now, it is... Dundalk, well, Dundalk, in a second then, the Dundalk's game, we're going to try and play this for you on a Thursday night in Europa League, so I'll get into that in a second, guys. Then we have Inverness, I think it is, on the Saturday or Sunday, which will be okay for us, back in, okay then. So, Champions League, it is Ireland versus Scotland. It is Aberdeen versus Dundalk at Aberdeen, and your competitors are Martin Tyler and Alan Smith, but we sadly can't hear them today. It is a great atmosphere though here. We were fourth in the league, but if we win tonight, we'll go top of the league because we are alphabetical order here tonight. But if the team say in second or third or the other game win by more goals than we do, then they will win, if you know what I mean, simple as. The referee tonight is Hammond Finnegar, and it is Ireland versus Scotland, the pride of the nations here depends on us. So it's Aberdeen versus Dundalk at Ivory Lane. Let's get in here, and that is what they've given us for the our ground here. It is a different kind of atmosphere tonight. It's a Europa League atmosphere, not a, oh, it's only a Scottish Premiership game, it's not an important game. It is a bigger, I think it's a bigger occasion than the Irish, than the Scottish Premier League, but we'll go with it here as it's up already for Stock City. We can take the shot here. Oh, what a save from the keeper. Reggie, we've only played about 5 to 6 minutes here. We've played 2 minutes on the clock and it's already been a corner here. Headed on here. Good save from their keeper here. Rogers, who can boot it the pitch now. He's booting not that far really. I thought he'd boot it further than that, but he doesn't. He only boots it to about where we are now and it's straight to Stocksey. Who can turn back, cut back, who can pass it in, who can head it out away, who can get the keeper and clear it away there. Far out, one of our players, Shiny, who doesn't get a touch there, and it's cleared away from their players here, and it's now going to be whipped up the pitch. Here it is. Quite far, actually, and they now are going to press and try and score here. Southampton have just scored, and apparently Shane Long scored the goal. I just heard that when you guys didn't. Apparently Shane Long scored the goal there for Southampton, so well in Southampton, they're 1-0 up here. Dundalk here on the attack. Dundalk with the shot here. Dundalk about to shoot, here they are, and don't score. But what a chance that was for Dundalk there. They had the opportunity to go 1-0 up here tonight, and they haven't made it count. As again, they try to go 1-0 up here. Doesn't count it again, as it is still Alexander in goal here tonight. The second keeper's in goal tonight. We had to change the team a lot because the keeper on the first game, if he played 1 minute of football, he'll be injured. And I know I could have put him in training, but keepers don't normally train that hard in training, apparently. I don't really train keepers much, so you know I don't really try. Dundalk player offside there, so we'll come back with some goals or some action. As the other Irish team, Cork, are 1-0 up as well against Ghent. So Ghent are doing quite bad as well. They're losing to Cork. I have a few games that they've randomly selected for me that are going to be played here. That's what I said. It's a free kick here. My player gets the foot on the ball, Raymond. Raymond does. Is it going to be a red card for Raymond? And it is. Raymond is off. Mark Raymond is off the pitch there in the cup. And that is disappointing. But he's off as they have a free kick here. Take Duffy with the free kick there. Oh, it's hit the bar there. Is it going to be cleared away? It is, as far as Stocksley there too. Stocksley now can run with the ball here. He can. I have him on ultimate team, I do. Oh, I actually don't anymore. But let's see, with a shot. Good save from the keeper. Double time save there. As it is whipped up here into the box, headed on here by the defender here, and it's straight at the keeper there. But the Gregor there can boot it away, only as far as the defender there. But it's great chances there we've had, more chances than they have, and they just haven't paid off tonight, guys. And I would say on a Tuesday night, Tuesday night would be better than a Wednesday night, but yeah, we didn't qualify for Champions League. Only Celtic can bloody qualify for Champions League. That's what I can bloody say. Owen Dundalk, as I talk, just a year about we can't qualify, have scored, and the captain scores. The captain But Dundalk has scored. Now let's watch this here, look. We try and slide the player there, we do. We leave that captain open. The if I didn't circle that player, I will definitely... Look at that, he's marked him. Unmarked there to plot it into the... him to the keeper's right-hand side corner, but to us, the left-hand side corner. And it was Scott O'Donnell... Stephen O'Donnell there with the goal there. What a goal from O'Donnell. As it's as there, we just don't manage to get that into the box. It's really what I expected from us here, to get it into the box and to score tonight. Dundalk, I think, are in a not to be offensive to Ireland, I would say we're in a worse league than the Scottish Premier League, because of just it is worse league than the Scottish Premier League. But as the Irish team say, I think Ireland's league is okay. It's not the worst league, it's not the best, but we should be winning because we have a better team than Dundalk, as I have said. As they get a free kick, so we're going to stick with us for a second here. Is it going to be another red card here, or is it going to be yellow as the player is being brought out here by the ref? If it's a second red, I'll be well annoyed here. It's only a yellow though, and that is good there. I think that's O'Donnell. No, it was Considen, or whatever his name is. Tell me if I correctly, please, by sending me a thing that you know his name, but I don't. And you know, really annoying me, I don't know his name. But anyway, it comes here with the hit here. He gets the free kick there, but no, he doesn't. And it's a shot, and it's a second goal for Dundalk. Is it the captain then? No, it's not the captain, but it was a good goal for Dundalk here. Look, we just left it open there, the player on the left-hand side there, and he just slots it back, the right left-hand side for him, and the right side, and no, the left-hand side for keeper, and the right-hand side for him. Patrick McGinley there with the goal, and he is just dominating this game. Tonight, I said to you, we have to win. We don't have to, because we still have two games left, still have loads of games left in this, but I would like to win, I said. And I think it's because I don't have a strongest team out. I think that could be considerably why I don't do well here. Look at that team. Already there are players who are getting injured in this game. I will be back with the rest of the game. There, as we have played not that well really in this first half so far. With 1 minute dead on the clock to go. It seems like before half time, it seems like plus added time we've got yet, but so it's not. We've got 3 minutes, 4 minutes away by the time. Because we are not going to classify to win this game. I asked the big million-dollar question: will we win any game in this league? I didn't make the group, but I thought the group was easy. Like, the only teams I thought I wouldn't win was Southampton, because they've got Shane Long. They've got like Shane Long, I thought to myself, they've got a better team than this, but no, seems like they haven't. And what a save from the keeper there, as that was Christian, I think, there, who was going to try and score, as Hayes whips in the ball here. It's headed away by us there, as far as Christian there with the shot. Oh, what a save from the keeper there, to deny us there from ever getting a goal in this first half, as it's a call. Oh, the whistle blows there and it's half time. I'm really annoyed, but I'm going to tell you quickly a run through the games at half time here in the group. We have in the group Cork are beating Ghent 1-0, which is a surprise tonight. It is where's Southampton? Southampton is still winning 1-0. They are Man U. Man United is 0-0 still, so yeah, literally, like, I thought it would be different here. The only other game that I'm surprised by is Valencia losing to Berlin there. We'll be back with the second half, for the full second half. Because we're losing, I'm risking 3 subs here. The keeper's come off as well, just because I thought the keeper that we have, Ryan Lewis, I think his name is, or Adam Lewis, is better than the keeper we had on Alexander. Now, no offence to Alexander, he did do a performance there. He did save 3 shots, and I think it was 2 or 3 anyway. But he did let goals in, which I'm really annoyed about. But we have to just take consideration today, we do, with what he does. As we've now got Adam Rooney on the ball there, can't keep the ball there really for more than 2 seconds. as it's Cork who are 2-0 up against Ghent. That's a really surprise there. It's Adam Rooney with a shot here. Adam Rooney with a shot. As it's a corner kick now. So Ghent, so I don't know Cork's team, but Cork are 2-0 up here. They are here as it's headed on now. It is. It's going to be a corner kick again here. Hopefully it's going to go to the players who they want it to go to here. It's gone short here, which they're not surprised about. They're not, as they've made a sub here. They have. As it's Shine with the shot. And it's another corner here. A goal kick here because it just deflected off our player, apparently. I thought it was theirs. But if you pull up Patrick McGinley, he's travelled 1 kilometre, touched it 15 times, and there dots for where he touched it. Pretty spread out, really, and loads it. 4 times he's done it in our box, loads of times in this half here. He's only travelled 1 kilometre, as that was weird from their player there to clear it out straight there. Our manager, mate, is looking worried. The manager there is looking worried, he's thinking, well, we should be no offence to be honest, but I think we should be 6-0 up here. As the new player who's just come on here has took the shot there, he has, and it's gone out for a goal kick here. Disappointment there from Dundalk. You think to yourself with Dundalk there, they were going to score, they were going to win. No, they're not. No joke. They are not going to score, not going to win this game. As the block is in there, and Bayern Munich bought Hamsik, which I'm surprised about because nobody really liked Hamsik. No, I'm no joke. And I don't really like Hamsik, and I don't believe they should have bought him, but anyway. As quickly, we're just going to get Shine here, look to pass it up here to Adam Murray. For Stocksy here with a shot. Stocksy, oh, what a block there from the defender. He is putting in an effort tonight, that defender is. Whoever that lad is who is the defender, well done him, as he knows that. I'm just going to be honestly brutal with you. He knows what he's got to do, and he knows what he's got to do. Sorry, I'm being racist here tonight. But he knows what he's got to do, and I think he's just trying ever so hard here, as we know he would do. As loads of players here tonight are trying on the good game tonight, they are, as Stocksy here, pass it straight to him. Adam Murray now. Adam Rooney can take the shot, and it's a save from the keeper there. I wouldn't believe it would be, but it's a save from the keeper. Disappointment there for Adam Rooney, and we should be 2-0 up here. We're now going to go for a quick break and be back in a second. So back we are now with the game, and look at this now. It's going to be even now, it is, to the side. Who's going to do this? Adam Rooney here with a shot. And it's in. What a goal from Adam Rooney. He scored a brilliant goal there. That's what the subs do. They come on, score goals quickly there. From about 30 yards out, he flashes at him. The keeper has no chance. The crowd here are saying, come on, we can win. Draw this now or win this. Here they are. And it's going to be ever so slightly one of the games tonight of the day. This game is one of the day games. Man United game is still 0-0 here. We have that as a featured game apparently here tonight. And Berlin are drawing with Valencia now. Now Valencia have got Berlin drawn here. As Stocksley here can just turn away here. No, he can't. Apparently he can't turn away from the player there here. As Dundalk here tonight need, I think, the win on their name. Just to make them happier here, I think, tonight. It will. Generally happier, and it'll put the smile on their faces, to be honest with you. But Stocksley here tries to win and get the ball there, he does, can't win it there. We've now down to 10 minutes to go. Here we are, literally got about 10 minutes to go now, and all eyes are questioned on if Dundalk can keep the win, or if Aberdeen can keep get a late winner or an equaliser. Is the case here tonight. I think it'll be a late equaliser. I don't think it'll be a late winner, as we only have 6 minutes to go of the game. We have here is the free kick for Dundalk. Here is going to be whipped in here. They've only made no fouls. We've made 4 or 5. It says 5 there. I can't read really. Well, I can, but you know, it didn't give to see there anyway. As Paulette here with the shot, and it hits the post. Now that was a close shot there from Paulette. It shows you everything about this team here. They really want to win this game, but to be honest, with 4 minutes to go here, now we're into 2 minutes to go, this game's getting quicker and quicker down the drain. I don't think we will get the winner that we deserve, as the defender there clears it with about 30 seconds left before we get added time here, as it will be added time on here, because we have had some free kicks to take. It'll be 3 minutes, sorry. As it is a corner here for Dundalk. Quickly, Dundalk have been told to take this corner. As they've took it quicker now, they will. They've taken it now. It's going to be crossed in. Keeper's going to save it. He's going to throw it out there as far as Adam Rooney. But Adam Rooney there can't do anything there. And it's a free kick to Aberdeen here, who want to take it quickly. They do. And they take it quickly there. They do. But it's straight back to Dundalk. There it is. As that should be offside there. But Dundalk haven't been given offside. It's just over the bar there from the Dundalk player there. The keeper saves it there. This is nail-biting stuff here. If you're watching this for the first time, please give this a fat up like. And Stubby, if you have just joined us here for this first ever episode of this thing here. As he throws it away there. He doesn't get a touch on that here. Will they take this last shot here? They will take the shot there. And it's gone in. Dundalk have scored a third. It's 3-1 here. And it is Benson there with the goal. I don't know his first name, but Benson with the goal. There it is, Robbie Benson there with the goal, first goal in Europe, as Aberdeen take the shot there, and it's straight, it's the keeper to save that, as Dundalk, the 1,000 away fans there, cheer, they get the win tonight, and Aberdeen, for the first game in this thing, do not get a goal there. As we look back at the save in the first couple of minutes here, this is what should have gone in, but didn't. That should have gone the other side of him. The goals were from Dundalk. If I just show you this here, there, we should have marked him there, Their second goal, just before half time, the player got tripped again, picked himself up, should have been marked again, he should have, but wasn't, and it was in the back of the net. Rooney, though, came on in the 68th minute and did this. Rooney with a shot, beautiful there from Rooney, good goal from Rooney, and then Dundalk thought, right, I'll get Robbie Benson was the player who was unmarked to slit home a goal in this cup, and it's all not good for the team for Aberdeen here. The manager probably be sacked here, but we will just quickly look and see what the game was, the other game in this. We will quickly. Southampton won 2-0 against Michelin, and did Cork win 2-0? Yes, they did. So it's a press conference for a couple of days here. There's some players who are suspended, players who can't play in the next match. There is international things, if you really want international things. Loads of stuff to talk about here with the team. Look, no red cards apparently have happened there for the league, so that's great to see there. So we're going to go into the next game quickly now for you, and we're just going to sim it, because we have to sim one game in this, and it's against Inverness at 4 o'clock on a Sunday here. Hamilton have won 2-0, the team did anyway, so let's just check and see what the score is here. As yellow card already to Aberdeen there it is here, as it's 35 minutes gone here, 0-0 still here. Who do you think's going to win this game here? To be honestly, I do not know who will be here. Is it going to be a 0-0 draw here? Rooney is on here, and Aberdeen have scored, and Hayes has scored straight after there. He has in the 71st minute. 67th minute was their goal, and it's 1-1 full time, which, as a matter of fact, if I look at the league, puts us in 7th. So it moves us one place above them, above Inverness there. It does, into 7th there. Nothing really too canny for that there. As we go into the last simmed match on this video today, we do quite a few today, and it's against Hamilton. Here we have to sim it, because we do. As here we go then with the simmed game here, Hamilton that lost for Inverness. They lost 2-0 there versus Inverness. It was the last couple of games there they lost. As here we go then, a yellow card already given there, as it's Dundee 1-0 up against Inverness. There, that's what we got to see there. Motherwell 1-0 up against Ross County there, as we've scored with Logan. Logan has scored here. Will that be the win? Him, it's 1-1 now with Inverness Dundee. there, and it's 2-0 against. So it's 2-0 Motherwell. Motherwell now 2-1, and Dundee win it. There they do. As yes, we win it 1-0. 1-0 win there in the last game for you guys. So thank you very much for watching. Next game will be your Dundalk. Will be your Europa League against Southampton at Southampton, I bet. But I being Casual 5 here, hit a like, subscribe if you are new, and I will see you in the next video, guys. Bye.